A huge shout out to Backcountry for partnering on this winter episode, because with their massive catalog of all things outdoorsy, combined with the freezing Canadian winter weather coming up, it was the perfect opportunity to winterize my carry. And these are actually really cool. So let's check it out.
Now, if I'm heading outside this winter, it's going to be in this outfit. Backcountry has 1,001 items to keep you warm, but this pair of overalls, the Foreman from Roark, instantly caught my eye, and I had to have it. Made of some heavy duck canvas construction, it's got elasticized shoulder straps with metal hardware throughout and plenty of coverage around back too. Now, the Foreman overalls have a supple amount of pocketing, making it my new favorite piece to wear whenever the weather channel hits below single digits. But Backcountry carries the most amount of overalls I've ever seen, if this isn't your jam. We'll dig deeper in a bit, but first, keeping my toes dry are the Adidas Outdoor Terrex Swift R2 GTX hiking shoe. Right off the bat, it's a little overkill in terms of features and price, but when it comes to Canadian winters, you can never be too safe. Plus, you do get what you pay for here, which is important given its one job is to constantly battle the snow, ice, and sludge around the city. But stepping on ice with these chunkers is like licking a pole during winter. It's got grip for days. And with the ripstop Gore-Tex upper combined with the thick AF rubber sole, you can bet that your toes are gonna stay drier than your laundry. On top of that though, it's one of the lightest boots I've tested, thanks to the thin but breathable material choice, which means it doesn't require thunder thighs to simply walk to the corner store. There's also plenty of padding on this mid-ankle model, so it's now surprisingly one of the comfiest boots I own too. Moving to the opposite end up top, y'all know I love my hats, and the winter can't take that away from me thanks to this Filson insulated tin cloth cap. It's totally got this seasoned construction dude vibe with this dark tan finish, but I'm totally for it, given this waterproof wax canvas finish can probably handle some rough environments too. Its real benefit is hidden inside though. Not only does it have a quilted lining, which basically feels like wrapping a tiny warm vest around your noggin, it's got these hidden wool ear flaps tucked away. I showed off a similar hat in my last video, and for anyone who likes keeping their ears from freezing off, this one is actually available to pick up on Backcountry. And right now, along with most of the other items, at a discounted price too. Moving underneath that, what turned out to be great for the winter so my nose isn't constantly red, a face mask. This one from Buff that I love not only for the Mortal Kombat vibes, but also how tight it sticks to my skin. Minimizing the amount of air gaps, and given how thin and flexible it is, it kind of looks and feels like you're slapping a large band-aid over your face. Which, don't get me wrong, it's great, because it tries to ensure the air you're breathing is actually going through the built-in filter. Hence why the material of the mask doesn't have to be a thick boy in itself. I love the dual overhead strap so my ears can take a break for once, and they're also adjustable in length for a proper fit. Now, I will admit, it's not the greatest for talking since it's so tied up against your lips, but if you don't plan on socializing too much, this is easily one of the comfiest masks I own now. Back to this beauty though, and its money makers, the large and spacious pockets. More than enough to store my new gloves, the lightweight ski gloves from Handout. Although designed for more active activities, they're also perfect for your urban adventures too, as the neoprene fabric is waterproof, keeping your ticklers warm, while still thin enough that you can still express your road rage with a single finger. But the secret sauce is in its name, opening the large zipper around back, you're now able to take your hands out. And look, not having to take your gloves completely off and having to find somewhere to put them just so you can grab something from your wallet, take a photo, or relieve an itch should already be reason enough for any city dweller. The fact that it has a really soft, fleecy interior is just an added bonus. A large zipper pull makes it easy to maneuver, and it's positioned in a spot that feels natural when sliding your fingers out repeatedly. The elastic Velcro strap around the wrist is nice to have as well, keeping the cold air or snow from getting in on the opposite end. I highly recommend these for anyone that owns a touchscreen phone, which the answer to that should be all of you. The pocket game doesn't end there, there's even pockets within pockets on this bad boy, and below that, there's even smaller sleeves, the backside one being perfectly sized to store and hide my iPhone 12 mini. But on the front is this tiny slot that I can only imagine was specifically designed for this, the Leatherman Free T4 multi-tool. Not your typically shaped tool, this one being like a Mars chocolate bar. But that's kind of why I love it, given it packs so much value into the size just larger than my finger. Like the star of the show, this 2-inch blade, as I'm a big advocate for always having a blade tool on you, just not at the cost of it taking up too much pocket space. But what makes this optimal for winter is the fact that everything can be done one-handed. Thanks to their new locking mechanism combined with the use of magnets, you simply roll your thumb and wha-bam. Choose your weapon of choice and it stays secured in place. Then, when you're done, unlock it with your thumb and twist it shut, as the magnets hold everything in place. I probably use the T4 at least twice a day, as it also includes a pair of scissors, one of my most used tools, and also the fastest deploying scissors I own too. It's also got other commonly used tools, a Phillips head, bottle opener, small flathead, and even a pair of tiny tweezers hiding inside the shell. You never know when those damn mole hairs decide to come out of hiding. With a metallic faceplate but plastic interior, it can take a beating, but also won't weigh down your pants when tucked away. It's also completely smooth around the whole exterior, so you don't have to worry about it tearing up your pockets either, making it the perfect tool to have on you at all times, just in case. Now, the single reason overalls reign supreme are because of the additional chest pockets. Roark kicks it up a notch by splitting it in two. Great to separate gear, like my wallet of choice, the Fjallraven Kanken card wallet. Similar to their really hyped backpacks, it's also made of their water-resistant G1000 wax canvas exterior in a fairly simple looking package. But once inside, you'd be surprised to find how much organization it offers. Two card sleeves on one side that I can comfortably fit three cards in each, with a zippered pouch on the other, which shockingly even fit my daily essentials. So when you zip it all up, whatever you're packing is safe from the outside world now. Well, everything except what you keep in the exterior quick access pocket. Don't worry though, it passed my scientific shake test thanks to the contents inside bulging out. Great for a transit card so you can tap or swipe without having to unzip the whole wallet. In the end though, having a tiny zippered pocket inside comes in handy for those sharper objects. But zooming out, the whole wallet itself is like a tiny pouch for other relatively flat tools too. I am curious. Comment down below what you'd carry inside this. Beside that is one of my favorite because hydration is major key. The Hydro Flask Packable Bottle Sling. This soft little baggie that when unfolded becomes a mini sling shaped exactly for a water bottle. Hear me out. If you've ever been out and about and got thirsty so decided to buy a bottle of Mountain Dew, well, you've now lost a whole hand as it's stuck holding that bottle now. But in comes a dedicated sling bag for said bottle that took up basically no space prior to it being summoned. Just think about all the great things you'll accomplish with both your hands free now. It's made of a ripstop material that feels very thin but can handle wear and tear really well. And bonus, its mesh carry pocket also doubles as a great card, keys, or AirPods holder too. This one is a no-brainer if you like to drink, well, anything, as it weighs nothing when not in use, packs into itself so there aren't any loose straps, and can easily be tucked away into any small crevice on you. As for the rest of the gear though, there's these, the Chrome Industries utility pouches. Chrome is famous for their indestructible bike bags, but it's no different with their smaller accessories too. Built with the heavy duty 1050D nylon exterior, basically the good stuff that'll keep whatever's inside safe, and lined in a water resistant tarp to keep it all dry as well. The small size here will fit an iPhone 12 Pro, AirPods, a charging cable, and a mini hard drive too. All things I'd usually carry in a bag, but definitely care enough about to want to double up on protection. And the Velcro strip works as expected while still allowing for quick retrieval of your gear. They do offer a larger size too, with everything exactly the same, except this one can easily fit my regular notebook. These are perfect to toss into a bag or your oversized pockets for a simple but secure way to winterproof the rest of your gear. Finally, this teddy bear skin I never want to take off is the North Face Campshire pullover hoodie. Honestly, it looks soft on camera, but when feeling it up for yourself, it's about 3.7 times softer. Seriously, there's not much else to say. The whole sweater is made of this fluffiness. What more can you ask for on a cold winter night? Oh yes, more pockets, which you have here as well, with zippers on both ends, something I didn't think I needed until I got this. When it gets a little too toasty, you can also unzip and air out without having to take the whole thing off, and it's even got elbow patches, as it's the most common spot to constantly rub up on a table. Lastly, to complete your transformation, the built-in hood is also fleece-lined, so you may or may not get mistaken for a panda bear. But combine that with the Roark overalls, this is the combo I will be wearing for the next several months.
Backcountry actually has a wicked sale going on right now, so check the description for all the details and links for everything I featured in this episode, but that's it. I rest my winter EDC.